Biggest fights of my life.
Really?
Luckily, I almost fell like 1 meter from the anchor. And all of a sudden, like somehow I slipped and I was like, wah! But like my thumb somehow got stuck on the one flake and I was like, ah! No, I'm not falling. That stop out is like 7A. And I was so fucking concentrated that I don't slip, but then I slipped anyway. Like, all of this muscle are dead from just doing too much, like,
climbing in Bosnia during the 70s and 80s was following the climbing trends in Europe, but unfortunately in the 90s we had a war here. So we really had to start all over from the beginnings. So one small group of enthusiasts made a climbing wall, small one though, in 2001. And then with a lot of work and energy, we managed to make a first sport climbing routes around Banja Luka. We really didn't have that much funds in that time, so we were collecting like 3 months to buy bolts for one route, and then so excited to place. The beginning was very slow, but we really enjoy doing this, and that's why we are here now. I have a deal for you, you cannot refuse. Take this and accept Bosnian citizenship. It's good for you, man. It's good. It's fortune.
Thank you so much.
It was really a pleasure to having you. I knew you are a great climber, but you are also a great guy to hang out and everything. Yeah, Bernardo,
thank you very
much. Such a nice
crew.
It was a pleasure to meet you all.
We are in Aničakuk. I have done the first 3 pitches. The first 2 were kind of like 6C, then there was one 8A plus, which I was kind of worried about. It was quite technical climbing, but in the end it went all right. And above my head there is a 4th pitch, 8C, the crux of the whole route, and it looks really amazing. Can't wait to climb it. It's pretty steep. The first half of the pitch is maybe not so hard, but then it gets even steeper and probably small hold, so.
mm.
Super happy, that was a fight. This, even though this is AB plus pitch and the lower one should have been 8C, this one felt much harder for the onside. It's like this open dihedral with no holds. I somehow made it up to like almost the top, but there it's getting like more overhanging and my eyes were just scanning all over and couldn't see anything. And at the same time, I couldn't really like hang around for anything longer because the holds are bad. So I just crimped something, tried super hard, brought my right foot up and somehow didn't fall. Then I obviously get super pumped and super tired and super nervous on the like this last layback where I definitely didn't climb very nice, but luckily I didn't fall and made it to the anchor. So here I am and the next 8A plus is remaining and then two more 7Cs and then the summit. So I have to fight for my onside now, so the next 8A plus will be definitely unnerving and then I can enjoy it to the top.
To do this route, to try to do it onside, it was, you know, like, this guy's arrogant, probably, you know? I mean, how can you do it on site? Meeting him, not that he's not arrogant, but he's so great that I'm blown. And Spomin on site, the whole world will hear about it. And everybody will say,
the route that I have just done tackles like the arête of this cave and climbs on these like perfect tufas and just keeps going for like 50 meters like that. It has some rests, it has some knee bars, but all in all it's pretty intense with like different sections and pretty hard boulder problem right at the very end of the cave where you're just exhausted and you almost want to vomit, but you just can't let go. It was quite a trip, and that's why I call it the Czech trip. And I really like the fact that it is called trip, because if you really climb the route, it feels like a trip. You're there and you're just really enjoying yourself.
You know, I'm working in climbing like 30 years, so every person like Adam Ondra, it's like present for us to share what we made here, to see what how he is thinking, how he is working, how he is climbing, to give some advice to us and to try what we cannot climb. So it's a present, but present like $1 million.
It's amazing feeling because you come to a place where nobody has ever climbed, nobody has been, and it's all for you, just waiting. And you're there and you just don't know where to start bolting. And if everything looks amazing, it's a really hard decision. First day in Albania was intense, but it's amazing. Such a good tufa lines. I did an 80 plus first ascent, which was already bolted. And then I was bolting this 50 meter mega line. And I don't know what's the time, 8 p.m. And it's bolted, it's cleaned, and I need to rest. Totally tired tomorrow. But the day after tomorrow, I'm back at it and I'm super happy with what I bolted. And B maybe? Hope so.